preach in the name of Jesus Christ, our risen Savior. Welcome to this morning's service as we gather to worship and celebrate Jesus, who is Lord and Savior. And welcome to all you who are gathered online as well. We are Bethel Church of the Nazarene. We exist to develop Spirit-led, Christ-like disciples in our church and our community. And one of the ways of doing that is by gathering together in worship and celebration. As we hear from God's Word, as we have fellowship, as we sing songs and offer our prayers, that we be reminded of God's presence in our life. So thank you for joining us. And as we gather, may you know His presence in your life today. A couple of announcements. Operation Christmas Child, boxes are still available. If you've already got them, bring them in by November 8th. And we'll make sure that they get to where they need to be after that. Also, special announcement, most of you have heard, but starting November 1st, which is Daylight Savings, we're going to be going to one service starting at 10 o'clock. And so we'll be gathering at 10 o'clock here in this space in person, and we'll continue online as well for those of you who are continuing there as well. May the peace of Christ be with you. As we join together this morning, may we stand and hear these words from Exodus chapter 33, as we continue the narrative from Genesis and Exodus, God's deliverance of His people. Exodus 33, beginning verse 12. Moses said to the Lord, "Look, you have told me, 'Lead this people up,' but you have not let me know whom you will send with me. You said, 'I know you by name, and you have also found favor with me.' Now, if I have indeed found favor with you, please teach me your ways, and I will know you, so that I may find favor with you. Now consider that this nation is your people." And the Lord replied, "My presence will go with you, and I will give you rest." "If your presence does not go," Moses responded, "don't make us go up from here. How will it be known that I and your people have found favor with you unless you go with us? I and your people will be distinguished by this from all the other people on the face of the earth." The Lord answered Moses, "I will do this very thing you have asked, for you have found favor with me, and I know you by name." Then Moses said, "Please, let me see your glory." And the Lord said, "I will cause all my goodness to pass in front of you, and I will proclaim the name, the Lord, before you. I will be gracious to whom I will be gracious, and I will have compassion whom I will have compassion." But he added, "You cannot see my face, for humans cannot see me and live." The Lord said, "Here is a place near me. You are to stand on the rock, and my glory passes by. I will put you into the crevice of the rock and cover you with my hand until I have passed by. Then I will take my hand away, and you will see my back, but my face will not be seen." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God. Let us pray. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires known, from whom secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Lord, receive these acts of worship as we lay ourselves at your feet. To you be glory forever and ever. Amen. Let us worship the Lord in song.
Oh,
Not because we don't ever have to do them, or because they're not going out, but Father, because you are with us. Oh, thank you for the beauty that we see around us, reminding us of your handiwork. From the sun rising this morning, the frost on the ground, to the colors still that are in the trees, or some of them. Even though it may be cold or chilly out, but we thank you for the warmth that you bring into our life, that you are our light, that you walk before us and lead us. Thank you that Jesus came and was our that special gift for us, his obedience to you. Father, as we gather, we praise your name, we hallow your name, we sing, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty." But Lord, we also offer the requests of our hearts, the burdens that may be weighing us down. Father, from jobs to family life, sickness and illness. Father, from the things that we see on our TVs and our screens. Oh Lord, we pray for your peace and your presence in those situations. We thank you for your safety that you provide for us along our travels this week. Father, we know that when there's trouble, when there's difficulties, not only that you're with us, but that we can run to you and that you protect us. So be our protection, be our safety, O Lord, today. We lift you to the requests of our hearts. For our loved ones, our family, our neighbors, co-workers, Lord, that need your touch today. Father, whether it be physical, emotional, spiritual. Father, those who are going in for surgery, I pray that you go before. Father, I pray for our country, pray for our leaders. God, that your peace would reign in their lives. Lord, we pray that you would remind them of you. Spirit, mold us and shape us this day. Fill us and use us in a way that we can only say that that's because of you. And cleanse us, O Lord. Father, we thank you for Jesus who has taught us how to pray. In moments and times when we don't know how or what to say, but Lord, we pray these words together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. And all God's people said, Amen. Amen. If you have your Bibles with you, or your screen, or tablet, or whatever it is, you open up to the Gospel according to Matthew, chapter 22. Begin verse 15. And looking through verse 22. We all like to seek approval, don't we? We like an attaboy, we like a gold star, we like that Sunday school board, right, that's got all the things accomplished. We like that attaboy. We like to seek approval, because when we seek approval, when we get approval, we know that we've done something right. And when we're a failure, we also know when we're a failure too, right? But more than anything, we don't want to be reminded that we're a failure. We want to be reminded that we have done a good job. So we try to seek approval. So sometimes we maybe go out of our way to seek that approval. Did you hear what I did? Look at me. Look at what I accomplished. Without somebody just coming on their own and saying, good job. And sometimes others come to us, right? And they just kind of butter you up. They say all these nice things about you. They may mean most of them, but they just kind of make you feel really good, don't they? But sometimes in the midst of that, do we say, what is really going on? What do they want from me? Somebody's not going to be that nice to me. Are they? Really? Talking about how great I am, what a great person, all the things that you do. It's just like, yes, you are awesome. I mean, yes, you may like that approval right away, right? Make us feel good, the pat on the back, the gold star, all that. Most of the time, I hope not, but sometimes when people say those types of things, there's a trap that's coming, isn't there? There's something that is just going to take you away from what all the buttering up was about. And that's kind of the setting for Matthew chapter 22. That the Pharisees are there and coming to Jesus only to trick him, only to trap him. But sometimes when that happens, well, at least for Jesus, Jesus knows how to get out of traps pretty well, doesn't he? But I wonder if more importantly than the trap is that we can learn something about Jesus' response to what the trap is. And so as we open the Word, as we hear His Word, may it breathe life into us once again, and may it ring true in our lives. It's a very familiar passage that many of us have heard over and over again. Most of the time we kind of quote this passage or these verses right around April 15th, and we kind of be reminded about taxes and all that, which we don't like taxes. That's okay, but we were reminded of this. And so often we come with all that information to this text. We come with our preconceived notions about what is happening. When we know that God's Word is alive, right, and it still breathes truth into us, it's not just a one-time thing, but it happens and breathes life into us over and over again. So I hope we would hear this with a new slate, if you will, a blank slate, clearly, that the Spirit can speak into our lives and hear His Word for us today. The Gospel of Matthew chapter 22. Hear the Word of the Lord. Then the Pharisees went and plotted how to trap Jesus by what He said. So they sent their disciples to Him, along with the Herodians. Teacher, they said, we know that you are truthful and teach truthfully the way of God. You don't care what anyone thinks, nor do you show partiality. Tell us then, what do you think? Is it lawful to pay taxes to Caesar or not? Perceiving their malicious intent, Jesus said, why are you testing me, hypocrites? Show me the coin used for the tax. They brought him a denarius. Whose image and inscription is this? He asked them. Caesar's, they said to him. Then he said to them, give then to Caesar the things that are Caesar's, and to God the things that are God's. Then when they heard this, they were amazed. So they left him and went away. The Word of the Lord. Right? It's one of those familiar passages as we journey through the Gospel of Matthew. And this is like no other. The Pharisees wanting to trap, wanting to trick Jesus based on his teachings and say, hey, we're going to set you up. So they sent his disciples. And the Herodians joined them, who were faithful to Herod, the Roman government. And so you have the two sides, the Jewish teachers of the law, and then you also have the Herodians, those who sided with the Roman occupation. And they come to Jesus and they say, hey, Jesus, you are amazing. You are so awesome. You speak the truth, and truthfully you speak it. And so you are just amazing, and you just speak the Word of God, the way of God. You don't take sides with anyone, and you're honest. Man, Jesus must be feeling awesome about himself right now, huh? Awesome that the Pharisees would butter him up like that. Well, we know, and Jesus knew, there's something else happening here. And then it switches to this question. Is it lawful for us to pay that tax to Caesar? What do you think, Jesus? Speak truthfully. Speak honest to us. We want to know what you think. It's a trap. If he says yes, then all the Jewish teachers and all the Jewish people are going to be up in arms. We don't want to continue to pay this tax to Caesar. That 50% tax, it is just outrageous. They're oppressing us. We don't need to pay that anymore. And then there'll be an uprising against Jesus, and Jesus said, yes, pay the tax. But the Romans would be like, yeah, this is awesome. Jesus is in agreement with us in the Roman occupation and the Roman government. But if Jesus were to say, no, don't pay the tax, the Jewish people would be, yes, we're free from this oppression. We don't have to pay the tax anymore. The teacher Jesus just said, we don't need to. But the Romans would be like, what? Speaking out against us? We're going to have you. You can't speak against us. Do you understand the trap? No matter which way he answered the question, if he answered it either way, there's going to be fallout. Something bad is going to happen to him. The people are going to say, you're not our true leader. You're not going to be our teacher. The Romans will be like, you're done with it. But Jesus knew their intentions. He knew their heart. He knew why they were asking the question. And he called them hypocrites too, didn't he? So he asked them, bring me a denarius. I don't have a denarius. I have a dollar bill. Whose inscription is on the front? Whose image is on the front of it? They said, well, Caesar's. Right? On their coin, on the denarius, Caesar's image was imprinted on there, and it had, this is a god. This is our god, basically, on their coin. Did you see what Jesus just did? The Jewish leaders had an image of Caesar in their pocket. Well, that went against the second commandment, didn't it? Idols? Images? No graven images? But Jesus didn't call them out and say, hey, look at you. You're breaking the second commandment. Because they were able to use that money as well for their taxes. They also had their own, the Jewish leaders, their own money that could be used for the tax as well. But Caesar's image was on that coin. And then the famous response, right? That Jesus says, give to Caesar what's Caesar's. That coin, it bears his image, it must be his, give it to him. Just like we should pay our taxes as well. But then he adds something else. He says, also give to God what's God's. What's God's? What's God's? I'd like for us to think about this word image for a second. The image that was imprinted on that coin, the image that the people had to pay their taxes with Caesar's on it, that image is also on us. Not the image of Caesar. But God's image is imprinted on us. You look back at Genesis 1, chapter 26, right? So God created man in his own image. He created him in the image of God. He created them male and female. We are created in God's image. Caesar was created in God's image. All 7.2 billion people or more, is probably more, whatever the number is now, have been created in God's image. Do we all act like we bear God's image? Do we give ourselves back to God? If we're His, then we need to give ourselves back to give God what is God's. We are His. We are His image. He has stamped upon us His image that we would be like Him. Even with those people who we just don't agree with, guess what their image is? Their image is the image of God. For I have created them in my image. In our image. Male and female. They're in the image of God, and so therefore there's a respect that needs to come with that as well. Jesus knew the trap. Jesus saw the trap. And Jesus basically gave a non-answer with an answer. Continue to give to Caesar the tax. I know you don't like it, but continue to give. But also remember, give to God what's His as well. Are we giving God ourself, all of ourself, with His image on us, to bear into this world? There's an old song that we used to sing. I think I've heard it in the last few weeks. Oh, to be like thee, blessed Redeemer. And then fast forward the song a little bit. Stamp thine own image deep in my heart. Oh, we ask God to stamp us, right? To seal us, to put that image within us and that inscription within us to say that we are His child, that we are His. And He has. Have we given Him ourselves? If we are His, we need to give Him ourselves. And all that we do, not just once a week, but every day, be reminded that we are His image. And for many of us who seek approval, self-included, we look for that in other areas, don't we? But the image that we need to bear, the image that we need to remember, is that God has created us to be His. That the approval doesn't come from somebody else, but it comes from Him. That He stamped His image, His love, His grace, that I am a child of God upon our hearts and our minds, that we are sealed with the Holy Spirit, the Spirit dwelling within us, encouraging us as we are His image. So give to Caesar what's Caesar. Give the dollar bill to the government. But also give yourself. As we are people within a kingdom, right, the kingdom of God, Jesus is the King, and as He leads us, that He would be our image, that He would stamp that upon us and remind us that we are His. There's a lot of people seeking approval today, aren't there? Approval. Our approval doesn't come from man. Our approval comes from the one who created us, and loves us. Hope you hear, don't hear, don't be active in our world. Be active. But allow ourselves to continue to be Christ in this world. It's hard being part of two different kingdoms, isn't it? The kingdom of God. Jesus is Lord of our lives and all that we have and all that we do, that He is Lord. But also the kingdom of this world that so easily pulls us to be where they want us to be. Where the image is all about the one on the dollar bill, the one on the TV, the one in our schools, the one who is the best. God says, you are my image bearers. be love in the world. Be my hands and feet. So maybe our prayer this morning is, Lord, stamp that image back on me. Not that you've lost it, but stamp that back within us, that we be reminded that we are your child, that you love us, that you care about us, that all that we do, Lord, be about you. And then when traps come in our lives, when we start seeking approval, may we be reminded that he is the one that we have given our lives to. Because Jesus gave his life for us. What a glorious day that is. When Jesus, who is Lord and Savior, went to the cross for us. In living, he loved us. In dying, he saved us. That we could be his image, the bearers of his image. And it's only through his life-giving, Jesus' life-giving into us, that we can walk with him. I don't know if you're the Lord saying to you this morning. Let me be reminded. There are many different images in the world today. Many different pictures that we see in our world. But more importantly, that we need to see Jesus. And that we need to see God's image in each one of us and in our world. So Lord, give us eyes to see. Give us ears to hear. Even those people that we may totally disagree with, that we may even dislike, that we would see the image of God in them as well. But first, let's give to God what's God's. Let us pray. Holy and gracious God, we thank you for this day. We thank you that you have sent your Son to be our Lord and our Savior. And that today that we can declare that you have created us in your image. And Father, it's just a simple truth. But sometimes, Father, in the midst of life, we forget that we've been created by you and for you and in your image. And that we are special and important. But Lord, we pray that we would be more like Jesus. Help us to see others the way that you see them. Help us to speak words of truth and life. Oh Lord, may we be reminded of the way of Jesus today. That he spoke truthfully, lovingly. He loved those around us, even when they were totally different. Transform our hearts and our minds, we pray. We pray all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Let us stand as we worship our Lord in song. Thank you. Receive the benediction. May the peace and love of our Lord Jesus Christ go with you as you go to wherever you're going, as you move through the day. May you remember that you are image bearers of God. Be his light and his hope in this world. Go in his grace and his peace. Amen. Amen.